Front Row MMA, we're here in Guernsey, lock-in three with Jon Le Tocq, winner of the first K1 fight of the night. Big KO to finish it off. First round was very tight and competitive. Is that how it felt in there, or did you think you just had the edge a little bit?
Yeah, to be honest, I don't really know. It was. I think the nerves get you. You go in there with a game plan, but then it's sort of wait and see what happens. So it felt like a pretty fair round, the first one, yeah.
You know, what kind of fight were you expecting coming in? You know, do you get a chance to sort of see your opponents, or is it just...
I think the problem is because it was both of our first fights, there was nothing really to go on. You know, being Guernsey, you know people who might know him, but nothing useful, really.
And, you know, first time competing?
Yeah.
And what was it like? I've asked everyone so far who it's their debut. When that cage door closes, it's a little bit different from a ring. When that cage door closes, how does that feel?
Well, to be honest, I never fought in a ring, so I wouldn't know. But all I know is I started off most of the day, I was fine. And then you just start getting that panic towards evening. But actually, when I was waiting outside the door, I felt pretty good. I was actually all right when I got in the cage.
As I say, a competitive first round. I think towards the end of it, you turned it on a little bit more. Yeah. He it's going to sound disrespectful. I don't mean it to, but he was using some technique that looked a little sloppy. A lot of spinning technique that's, without being too offensive, you could see from last week. Is that where you saw the openings? Because, again, you seemed to pick him apart.
Yeah, I think I was trying to, by the third round, I knew what he was trying to do. And I'd walked onto a couple of them in the first couple of rounds. So it was just kind of step away when I saw them come and step back a bit. And I think that might have been when the knockout came, but to be honest, I'll have to watch it back.
And I hate to bring up an injury, but, you know, it's a pretty hefty hematoma bruise coming up on the foot. Would that happen in the first with one of the leg kicks?
I think so, yeah. I mean, I could feel my foot throbbing in the first round. And then it was only the second round I looked down, and that's probably the worst thing I could have done because it was just going black and blue, which screwed my head up a little bit, but... we've done the job in the end.
What was it? How do you... Let me rephrase the question. How do you feel your performance went tonight? What are you pleased with? And if you're going to get back in the cage of the ring again, what do you think you... What are you going to work on next?
To us, I think we had a game plan. I could hear my corner telling me what to do, but actually putting it into practice, you're still a little bit wary. So I think it's kind of learning to trust the corner a bit more. I had a great corner, man. But as everybody says, once you get in there, it's a lonely place.
it was a great performance. It was a fight that had the fans going as well. A nice split as well. Half the room seemed to love you. Half the room seemed to hate you.
Yeah, that's my life, really.
Join the club. Behind a performance like that, though, there's got to be people you want to say thank you to. People who have put up perhaps with your weight cut and training, what have you. Please feel free. Who do you want to say thank you to?
It's going to sound like an Oscar speech. First of all, my corner man, Robert. You can't see. He's been fantastic talking through the more tactical side of it. Because as we all know, you can do what you like on the pads, but in there it's a different story. My family have been really supportive. I know my parents in particular didn't want me to do it, but they know what I'm like. I'll just let me get on with it, and I'm glad I've come out safe and take a trophy home.
Are you looking? Is this a one time only? Are you gonna compete again?
We're gonna get pissed now. We'll see what comes up tomorrow.
Amen. You go and get pissed. Thank you so much for your time. A great knockout.
Thank you. Thank you.